Hello guys, so in this video I'm going to show you how we can clone any website design using one amazing tool. Okay, so in this video I'll show you a step by step everything. Okay, so we're going to clone this amazing website. That's really fantastic. Okay, so let's clone this website design. Okay, I don't have access of this website. Okay, so and I'm gonna clone this whole design in my new website. Okay, so how we can do this? So it's really very easy. So we need to use your one tool, and that tool name is ClonewebX. So what you need to do, you just need to search here Softlight WebClonex. Okay, WebClonex, and you'll find that website softlight.io. Just open this and you'll find here ClonewebX. This is tool. Click on check it now. And now as you can see here, you can easily clone any website to your page builder with a single click. As you can see, you can use your Webflow, Elementor, bricks. Okay, I already have created video about the bricks, and in this video we will learn how we can use Elementor and Webflow. Okay, so now let's click on the buy it now, and it's free also. You can use it a free of cost, or if you want to get some discount, so you can choose that 1000 site. So let's click on checkout, and here's one more coupon code. Let me show you. As you can see, you will find a 30% discount. Okay, and one more thing is, once you click the enter, and you can add one more coupon code is the coding bus, and just apply our channel name, and you will get extra 5% discount. It means $15 discount. You will get this discount in all the plans. Okay, now we need to click on the payment information and just check it out. After the checkout, you will see that dashboard. This will look like this. Now click on the add new project. Okay, and my project name is softcore.us. That's my website name and website domain. So as you can see here, that website I want to clone. So I need to use here this website URL. Let's go here, just paste the URL and click on create project. Done. We need to install this extension, ClonewebX Chrome extension. I already have it. So open the website and you will see here, this is the extension. Select this, and as you can see here, please select a project. Click on this. You see softcore US that we have created. Select this project. Make sure to scroll the whole website like this once before you click on that page. And now click on add page. As you can see here, this is the website. Now you can clone the any part of this web page. So suppose if you want to clone this part, okay, this is the iPhone part, this one. Okay, so you just need to select this. Okay, then you need to select the CSS like this, and as you can see here, this is the selector. You will find here this. Okay, and then you'll see the page builder. Now you can select any page builder, like let me just select the Webflow first. Okay, so click on Webflow like this. Okay, as you can see here, this is the export option. Now click on this export and wait some seconds, then copy this. Now let's go to the Webflow website, and you can see this is the one. Okay, website here. Now click on that add option, and you will see the, you can add any section. So I'm going to add here one section here like this. Okay, and now we just need to use the command V or control V to paste. So as you can see here, this is the website, just paste it. Okay, now what we need to do here, what I will do here, I'll just make this publish. Okay, and you can make it, you know, as a, let's just publish to this selected domain, and let's see how this will look in the website. Okay, and let me just open that Webflow page. Okay, I've just copied one section. And as you can see, this is really fantastic and amazing. Okay, that's, you just cloned someone else's website design like this. Okay, that's really fantastic. You can add more section here. Okay, you just need to do one thing here, like scroll down, and you can go again to the website here like this. You can go here, and if you want to clone this products, okay, design, if you want to clone this one design, so just select this. Click on the Elementor. Now let's click on the export option, then copy, then again go to the Webflow and go to the scroll down and just paste it. This is done. So you can paste like this, and you can just add the design like this. Okay, that's really cool. Okay, so now let's see how we can do this with Elementor. Okay, so here you'll see I have one website here, this one. Okay, click on the add new page. Okay, here new page. and click on the page option like this, and you can add your any page name. Okay, so let's, my page name is suppose it's a landing page. In the right side you'll find the option of this three dots. Okay, or you can select the templates. Okay, click on the page, and as you can see the default templates, so make sure this should be Elementor full width. Okay, I'll use the Elementor full width, and then click on this publish page. Okay, this is important. Now let's click on the added with Elementor. That's it. Now what we need to do here, before using this ClonewebX here, we need to do some settings. So first of all, we need to install one plugin here. So go to the ClonewebX, so whatever the section you select, suppose let's select this section, okay, and like the CSS, and once you select the Elementor here, and you will see here we need to install this softlight.io integration plugin. So click on this plugin download. Now go to your website, okay, here dashboard, in the left side you find the plugin option, click on add new plugin, and you need to install this plugin. Okay, click on upload file and install it. I already have installed this plugin, and you'll see here this softlight.io. You just need to install it and don't do anything. Now we need to go to the Elementor settings. Okay, here see the Elementor, go to the settings option, and you'll see the features option, click on this. Now scroll down and find the option of stable features, and you will see here the flexbox container. This should be active, this is important. Okay, make sure this should be active, and now click on save changes. Done. Two thing you have to do. Now again go to the back ClonewebX here, you see you need to install this. Done. And this is the setting we already have done. Now select any section, suppose let's try this section, select this CSS, click on the export. You can reduce the DOM size, okay, it's up to you. And let's click on the export option and wait some seconds, click on copy to clipboard. Now let's go to the here, this is the web page. Okay, now just right click here and see the paste from the other side, click on this, and now press command V if you are using Mac. If you are using Windows, so you just press control V. Okay, and wait some seconds. See, that's the awesome design. Okay, I just copied it, so this is done. Oh my god, fantastic. So same thing you can do again and again to copy the whole website here. Okay, I can show you the publish. Let me just make it the review. Let's try to review this, how this will look. You can change the menu. Okay, and as you can see here, this is the design. See, the same design that we have cloned theme in just few seconds like this. See, that's my original website here, this website design, this, and this is the clone website. See, fantastic. So this is the amazing tool. Using this tool you can clone any website design. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can ask me in comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.